So now let's come to another non-orthogonal machining process, which is turning operation. So I'll just reiterate the all the things related to non-orthogonal machining will remain almost constant. That is how I am going to model it. The value of psi, that is the side cutting edge angle, which has been introduced, which will be non-zero. So it was zero earlier, it will be non-zero now. So almost all the things remain same. The modeling always remains same. The formula remains the same. So let's come to turning operation. Turning operation means I have a lathe job and the spindle is rotating, the workpiece is rotating, and I'm going to do a turning operation on that. That means I'm going to remove and decrease the diameter. That is, I'm going to give you some depth of cut, and then I'm going to remove the depth of cut from all part. So let's look at that. Side cutting edge angle is psi. This is the triangle which is coming because of the force which are acting, and these are the distances. So this is the angle psi, and using this trigonometry, I'm going to relate depth of cut, width of cut with uncut chip thickness and feed rate. So using this trigonometry itself, I'm getting T1 is equal to F cos psi. And W is equal to D sin D by cos psi. So these are the same relation which I have mentioned earlier in the last video also about the shaping and planning operation. So this will obviously remain same for all the non-orthogonal machining processes. Now let's see this. So orthogonal tool has two rake angles, back rake angle and side rake angle, and we need to convert it to single rake angle alpha. So that's one of the job we need to do while solving problem. And we also need to check the condition for orthogonality for turning operation on lathe. So we have two angles, alpha B, which will be the back rake angle, and alpha S, which will be side rake angle. So before we were only having back rake angle alpha. Now we have two back rake angles. So we will define two. Now a condition has been given, that is tan alpha b into cos psi. This is not phi, the phi doesn't exist. This is cos psi is equal to tan alpha s into sin psi. So the phi is wrongly written. It is sin psi and cos psi. So if the above equation satisfy, then we can use the Merchant's and other solution for FC and the power calculation. So we know the formulas already. This is one of the condition for using those equations for turning operation specifically. And how to get the single value of side rake angle for formulas, whatever formula this FC and power calculations have, that have a single formula, a single value of the rake angle, and it doesn't have two values for back rake angle and side rake angle specifically. So we need to convert it to single value, equivalent rake angle alpha. So there is a formula given, but that is a very long formula, so I'll directly mention that in the numerical question. But this is the condition which we need to satisfy. This is the same condition I have mentioned earlier also. Tan alpha b cos psi is equal to tan alpha s sin psi. So the formula for that is this. There is another formula I'll mention about it in the numerical directly. So this is the thing which is very important for you practically also. We had a force, cutting force directly coming downward direction. And then we had a thrust force which was directly in the orthogonal machining. It was directed in this direction that was completely perpendicular to the face of the tool, face of the workpiece. So the face of the workpiece was here, and I was getting the FC directly in that direction. But now that was for orthogonal machine. Now if I am having non-orthogonal machine, that FC direction has been tilted. So now it is like this. It is tilted and it is at an angle. So this side angle is the side cutting edge angle. And now I am taking this components of this thrust force in this direction and the horizontal direction. So those are the two forces, that is the radial force and the feed force. And this was the thrust force from workpiece or by workpiece to the tool that was perpendicular to the transient surface or all the surfaces which are generated during the machining. So we have cutting force, we have radial force that is in the direction of depth of cut, feed force in the direction of feed applied, and using the angle, this is the angle that is the side cutting edge angle psi that the depth of cut direction makes with the thrust force. So this is the final equation which we need to use to get the three components of force. Fc equation we directly have from Merchant's theory. Ft we can find from the trigonometric relations and the Merchant circle. And then from Ft and the psi value, we'll find the feed force and the radial force or the normal force. So we'll end over here. Thank you.